So now this topic is how to create a manual number sequencing. So there are various ways to reach to the number sequencing menu item, number sequencing format. So the best way is go to the organization and administration, and there is a number sequencing. So click on this number sequencing. As we seen, we can generate the number sequencing to generate complete number sequencing formats for the legal entity. Now here we are creating a new number sequence. This is a one by one. So just go to this new and then number sequence. Here everything we have to give. So number sequencing code. So now we know that okay, this number sequencing we are going to use for the vendor account. So we should give the relevant name for that. So I just give VEND and then account. And then give the complete name in bracket name. So this will be easily understand. Okay, this is for vendor account, means vendor name. Then scope and parameter. So this scope and parameter is useful for whether this number sequence will be useful for all the legal entity or of only for my company. So generally each legal entity should have their own number sequencing. It should not be shared, but there are some number sequencing which are shared, which are by default system is creating the shared number sequencing. So in my scope I will select company or legal entity. So just select a legal entity. From legal entity you can drop down and select, okay, this is for GCA. So select your company code here. You can also type GCA. So system will select that legal entity. Now segment. Segment means there are three parts. So one is the legal entity which we have selected right now, or a company. Then the constant, which is a fixed value which is not changed during the number sequencing. And alphanumeric means the numbers which will be continuously changing, 1, 2, 3 per sequence, you can say. So now for my format, as company decided, okay, the legal entity or purchase vendor account code should be indicate like GCA/vend/ and 4-digit number. So if we want that format, then what we need, we should have the legal entity also. But the what is the advisable is just remove this legal entity from this format. In the constant, you have to type GCA/VEND/. So this is my constant value, which will never change. Then alphanumerical. In alphanumerical, I need 4 digits. So just remove additional hash, keep it 4 only. So how the vendor will be appear? GCA/VEND/001. Right? Now here this reference we don't need to give. I will tell the reference whenever we need to give. What we are going to do, once we create the number sequencing, we will go to that module or that parameter where this number sequence get attached. System will automatically add the reference. Then there are options called continuous manual number sequencing. In some company, there are manually they used to give the number sequencing. They don't need a continuous format. So in that case, we just click the manual one. So every time you need to type the vendor account code, and then system will check whether that code is already available or not, and then it will save it. In continuous, system will take 1, 2, 3, 4 automatically. And then here also, as we have given the maximum length is 4 digit, we also need to remove additional 9 from here and just put 4 9s over here. So this is what the total basic setups for number sequencing, and then you just save this. Now once you save, you just try to copy this code so that you don't need to forget that code. copy that code and then close the screen, go to the particular module where we want to attach that. Here it is vendor code. Vendor code is available into my parameter. In parameter, go to number sequence. Now here this code is not required. So what I will do, I will just paste my code. That is vendor account. This is my code. So I have created this code for that. So unable to find a unique number sequencing code record corresponding to the entered values. The system is not finding that number sequence code for that. So this is an alert. Just see that it is taking. Save this. Some of the information that entered not valid number sequence value. Maybe we have created some vendor's code into that. It's not allowing me to apply that. So we'll just, for example, payment voucher. So if it is not allowing, means it will not, we will not able to attach that number sequencing for that. So